There we go, back up to the top. Keep going, keep going. That'll do. That's perfectly fine. Oh, I'm making a lot of rare annoy. Yes, I'm making a lot of noise, aren't I, while I'm faff around doing nothing, and I've got to get this all sorted because I've got a lovely little area where we're going to do a nice little drive along for you. Yeah. Oh, fuck. So I better get it sorted. Better get it sorted. I better get it sorted because this is going to be a nice little drive along. I mean, a fucking long drive along. I might cut it short depending on how far we get and depending on how I feel. So, anyway, nevertheless, it's, that should be about right ish. It'll fucking do. That one's lefty. Yes, like I said. From where I am today, which is, it's Cardiff area, but I'll be honest with you, I'm not exactly sure which part. I came up off the M4 at the Merthyr Tydfil junction, which is 32, down the 470, and off and up, and then I took a detour, went up there, and over there, and around there, and over, you know what I mean? So at the moment now I'm just sort of here. I'm South Wales-ish area, near enough, and I'm going to make my way back home. Now I've looked at my sat nav and checked to see where it's going to take me, and hopefully it's going to take me up through all the hills down to the heads of the valleys road and what have you. And this time I'm in the goldfish truck, so at least then we'll have a better view. So hopefully, anyway. Let's go and get ourselves plugged in, shall we?
Yay!
Everything's all charged up, ready to go. Right. You are going on there. Good at this lock, and I think almost perfect. And just for you, and you know who it is. Ah, oh, I tell you what. I bet I come across as a right fucking neuter. Yeah, put you over there and round. Right. Right. Make sure everything's doing its thing. 10 minutes have gone already. Fucking hell. I think I've already found, but I can't remember, so I'm just gonna check. I've had one of those days today where I just can't, I don't even know my head from my arsehole here. Come on then, let's go. Let's get the flock out of here. And we're off, finally. Yeah. Right then, I said right then. Right then, indeed. Yeah. What do you reckon? Is that going to be all right there? Could be. Yes, we are currently in South Wales, sort of ish thingamajig near. I've got no fucking clue. I have no idea. No idea at all. And you're on the wonk, and I don't like wonk. Wonk does me fucking dead in. Still on the wonk. Not so much of a wonk. That'll do. Come on, dude, hurry up. Don't take a rocket science to get around here.
Oh, fuck. Couldn't you have parked that car somewhere else, you bloody great big plumpet?
Sometimes. Just sometimes. You just wish you could have an easy life day, you know? Just have an easy one instead of having to keep on and on and on and on and on and fucking on.
On and on and on and on and on.
Right then, I've got to go back up there, because you can't go down there, because the old way don't exist anymore, because it's all full of houses. That's why when I come down here, I was like, oh, I had to back up. I can't go that way. Why? Because it's just blocked off. Sunshine, no one is happy to me. Right then, we're going to go this way, and like I say, hopefully, fingers crossed, another bits and bobs. I've got to go this way, haven't I? It says I've got to go this way. Ooh. Ooh. Could it be?
Could it be?
Oh yes, I remember. It's all right. I'm having a moment. I've had moments all day today. Right then. Okay. I am going to tell you this story, right? Please don't hold it against me, right? I don't know why, I don't know where, I don't know how, I don't know what for. That must have caught fire at one point. So, this morning, as you know, now as you don't know, because this morning would have been the 2nd of November, and it's probably not the 2nd of November today, is it? No, probably not, no. What is it? The fucking 6th or something stupid? Oh, I don't fucking... Anyway, on the 2nd of November, which was a Wednesday, there I was, on my way to Wombourne, minding my own business, and I get down there with a bunch of pallets on the back of me. Pulls up to the place. Got some pallets for you. Oh, well, have you? That's unusual. Well, apparently they were supposed to have been delivered yesterday, around about 6 o'clock in the evening, but for some unknown reason they couldn't get to you. But you've agreed to have them this morning. All right. So the security guard radios through and says, got some pallets for you. All right, I'll be on my way. So he comes down. And backs in, the guy starts to unload me. Pah, fucking superb. I was there for half an hour. June, that was the end of it. Fucking super duper pooper scooper. So then I go off back to the yard, pick up another trailer, and give him the eye of a mouth, which is what I'm actually doing today. I know it's weird, isn't it? I love doing that, it just fuddled me muddled in it. Anywho, so I went off, got to Strensham, had half an hour break, because I did need to finish up a bit of a break. And then I carried on, and I gets down there, and probably around about, say, 40 minutes left of my journey to get to Avonmouth, and a phone rings. So I've got my free kit on, got the Bluetooth on. Yeah, make sure it's all legal beagle. And they said, you know that job this morning, do you have any problems with it? No. Why? Well, apparently they're saying they haven't delivered them. So I bloody have. I was there for half an hour. Are you sure you did them to the right place? The right place? What do you mean? The right place? Well, have you delivered them to the right place? Well, as far as I know, I have. Well, where are they supposed to go? This other place. What other place is that then? The one next door to the place you sent them to? And I'm like, really? So you're telling me that I've actually delivered these pallets to the wrong place and they've actually accepted them and signed the paperwork? Yeah. Well, I'll go too. It just so happens the place that I actually delivered them to, these pallets, we do deliver pallets there. So, and it just seems that it all seemed to like stem on to being this place that I'd been to before. I just got on with it. But they was going to go and collect them back up and send them back around the corner. And they've turned and said, no, you're not. So we're having them now. So they've ended up with the pallets. So it was, you know, they just had to organise a another load of pallets to the right place this time. So, you know, happy days. The other incident, I'm not going to mention that. And you can badger me as much as you like, I am not. Because if I did, well, it's just wrong. I don't know how, why, what for, but I'm telling you now, no. In about 10 years' time, I may recall the story of when today happened. But no, not now. I might leave as a retirement, a little retirement video or something. But no, not at the moment. I'll keep that one to myself. But I have no idea how I managed it. But hey, I'll just leave that to fester in your head. You know what I mean? You'll be there going, wonder what it was. What could he have done? What's he done? What's happened to you? Ooh, ouch. Well, like I say, you know, I could tell you, but I ain't gonna risk it. I am not gonna risk it. First risk it. No, not at all. No, never. Forget that crap. Now this is a bit of an awkward island. This is. I've got to go up there. Just checking, make sure I'm in the right lane. You know what I mean? I gotta go up here. Yes, up here is where I gotta go. Gotta go. Now I have been this way before, but it was a while ago. Oh, it was. Oh, yes. But if it all goes the way I'm hoping it goes, we should end up somewhere near the head of the valley, something like that, I think. I'm not 100% sure because, like I say, it's... It's one of those, you know what I mean? It's like, well... Something fucking poking me thumb. What the fuck's poking me thumb? Something's poking. Well, at least give us a bloody go at getting through. Stupid fucking lights. Oh, look at your thumb. It's got a weird itch to it. Yeah. Whatever. Yes, so, my day has gone really weird today. But as of now, like, you know, after all that, it turned out okay-ish. But, like I said to them, why did you send me down there at that time of the day? It's going to give me a fucking 13 and a half, 14 hour day. No, I don't like that. That's not fair. Fucking hate long days, I do. They just never seem to end. But... on a positive note, I suppose, I'm doing this now, so it's, I can use it to my advantage, can't I? You know what I mean? Sort of thing. So, I just hope this traffic doesn't last all the way up the road like this and starts junk, and I'm going to end up wasting battery power. We don't want that, do we? No. That's bloody boring. Bloody boring, that is. You just have to shoehorn yourself in. There's not a lot you can do, is there really? Bad design. An absolute crap design, the road is here. It's not good at all. No. See, that type of design there is guaranteed to snarl the traffic up. Why? Because people are people. The people on the right-hand lane who want to come up here, they know full well that it bottlenecks into a single lane, but they still are adamant they're going to get to those arrows. They've got to do it. Oh, yes. That's their fucking mission in life. Got to get to them arrows so we can cut in. But if they all had a bit of forethought and went, at those lights just after, it bottlenecks off. So if we move over now, we'd all get through and fuck off without even any kind of assholes whatsoever. Would you believe that? It's mad, isn't it? I know. I'm the only person out there that thinks like that. But hey, one day it might catch on. But then again, there's more than likely not, the automatic cars will be out before that happens, so there will be no manual driving at all in that decade. Oh, good grief. Yes. But other than that, though, you know, everything is, we're still here. There's no big boulders dropping down and wiping us out. We haven't got any conspiracies of such like yet. There's no alien activity, even though they keep saying there is, but I don't fucking believe it, but hey, whatever. So, yeah, you'll just have to keep your eyes to the skies, keep hoping and wishing, maybe, or apparently it don't happen. But there's lots of other things that could happen that you don't want to happen, and if that's the case, then you're knackered, ain't you? What did you say, Jace? I have no idea. As we poodle around this bit of... this is nice. It's been a long time since I've been down here. I just can't remember. But you've got to take advantage, so I've got the old cameras going and we're having a bit of a net, I mean, you ain't we? Me and thee are having a bit of a confab. Oh, well. It's all right, I'm just admiring the sights myself.
I do it sometimes, I just like to have a look. You know what I mean? It's just nice. I like it. It's cool.
I've booked my holidays. Not so much holidays, I've booked the day off to go to the hospital. It's on the 23rd of this month, but I've also extended it and so I've got Wednesday, Thursday, Friday off of that week. I thought stuff it, you know, I'm going to go to the office, I'm going to be poked and prodded, I'm thinking, you know what, yeah, I might not feel like it, you know what I mean? I mean, of late, I just don't want to fucking get out of bed half the time, but I'd rather get out of bed and go to work than be on the street. So, yes, it's one of those. It's one of those again, I'm afraid.
This is looking very familiar. I think I've been down there as well.
I'm not sure, but does that take you to an Easter egg place down there? I can't remember the fucking name of the place it's called now, is it? Bibbly Bobbly? Bobbly Bobbly? I don't fucking. Hubba Bubba? No. Bourbons? Bobbon. No, hang on. Bonbon, that's the one! Fucking Bonbon. That's down there, I think. Whoever lives in this neck of the woods, let me know if my brain's just switched on and gone, ooh, hello. Because you never know, these things are out there to try me. Right, where are we going now? We're still on the A472. Yes, just for those of you who didn't realise, but we are on the A472. And I am in the... I'm thinking that is the particular route that I am actually wanting. It'll take me. I fucking hope it does. I will cry if it don't. It should take me all the way down the valley, the heads of the valley, what, that thing, yes. I'm sure it does, at least it gets somewhere near there. I'm almost positive. I'm not going the same way I came back, that's for sure, so it's got to be doing something right, isn't it? This man truck, right? I am convinced that this is a Chinese knockoff. Right, I'm convinced it is. Right, because it don't work the same, it don't drive the same, and everything's just cockeyed and crap with it. It's a fucking nasty bag of rubbish. The gearbox is about as useful as a fucking second-hand Tampax. Rubbish. Absolute rubbish. It's got no go in it. It couldn't pull you out of bed if it tried. It's pathetic. It really is. I was told by one of the lads that new Volvo that I showed you, apparently it's a bit annoying because it's been limited to 52 miles an hour. I'm thinking, oh, that's boring, that, isn't it? I don't get that, Ardo. I understand the saving fuel and all that sort of shit, right? But if the vehicle's going to go slower, how can you expect the same amount of work to be done? Well, that doesn't make sense. That doesn't even compute. But hey, whatever. It don't matter. It'd still be a nice drive, I imagine. So there is always that. There is always that. Can I go? I'm going anyway, fucking hell. I've made my... See what I mean by that? Look at that. It's in seventh gear and I'm doing fucking 12 miles an hour. Fuck off. I mean, this... I pulls out of an island, right, and I was doing 22 and I was in 10. There's only two more gears left and I was in... I went, what the fuck? How are you supposed to get anywhere? He was on... the rev counter was reading 900. And he was in 10th gear, like, mauling its nuts off. I'm like, what the fuck? Whoever programmed the gearbox and its synchronisation and its changing system, honestly, what were they? Was it a bet or something? Did they lose a bet? Was they pissed at the time? Have they never drove a truck? There's a thought. You want to stick them in a manual and go, righto, take off down the street with a fully frayed. You go on, go and have a drive with a manual truck. And go and go to the gearbox. Now you'll see how it fucking works. Now what cock up you've made. Fucking bonehead. I know, but the thing is, I mean, you witnessed it. It's rubbish. Absolute fucking rubbish. We're going down a big hill. We're going down a big hill. We're going down a big, 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 big hill. Yeah, yeah. A coasting we will go, a coasting we will go, we are in area, a coasting we will go. Well, apparently, according to this, we are going to go left. But I don't think it's immediate left, I think it's the next left. Well, how about that, eh? There's a Mac Doodles here. I've got a funny feeling that might be the Mac Doodles that lad was on about. You going that way, are you? The wrong fucking lane you've been in. I've got a feeling that might be. Could be. You never know. We've got to go up here, apparently. You know when you turn down streets and you start to get nervous? Yeah, that's pretty much what I'm doing at the moment. It's. Oh, I'm a bit wary now. I am. I'm a little bit wary. Please, shall we come home? But who shall? And why ain't she home? Is he missing? I hope not. That's not good. That's not good at all. No. Right then. So, Technology Park is just up here. Never been, but sounds interesting. Technology Park, eh? Yeah. Them lights are on, Red Jace. That's true, that is. I'll slow the fuck down then. I am. Behave. We can go again. Watch this, ready? Second gear, right? Fifth gear. From second to fifth. Seventh gear, right? 15 miles an hour. And we're on 20 miles an hour. Ninth gear, right? Here we go. I ain't put the foot down. We're on 25, 26. Oh, we managed 26 this time before we hit 10th. Fucking hell. What the fuck for? It's just no good. It's no good at all. 11th gear. We're creeping on our way up to 40. Oh, happy days. Stretching up to 45. And it changes gear again. And then we're in 12th. 12th gear at 45. Why do a 60, then do that? That's you might as well just left that at fucking 30 or even 40. Because going from 60 to 30 is a bit fucking harsher than going from 40 to 30, don't you think? You should have left it at that. That was bloody stupid. I'm going up here. Ooh. Apparently I'm going up here. Ooh. Okay. What are you fucking doing to me here? Huh? Where are you sending me? Eh? This is not a fucking game, you know. This is my life you're fucking with. We're gonna have to have a chat, me and you. For fuck's sake. Oh well, let's give it a whirl. See what's what. It's one of those. I can see it. I can fucking see it coming. Manual, please. We need a bit of oomph to get up the hill. Nice and steady. Ooh. You're going to find it tight to get in there, Missy. Oof. I fucking find it tight. Can't beat myself. Good grief. Where am I going?
Well.
Oh, now the road's starting to make a bit more sense. For those of you who actually live in Wales area, or you know this kind of, this road, this area, this place, whatever, and you're probably sitting there tittering yourself thinking, oh no, where that ends up, yeah, I'm all right, Jase, don't worry about it. You're watching me panic, ain't you? And you're laughing at the same time. Git. It doesn't do much for my constitution, this, doesn't, you know? No. Good grief. Told you. There is absolutely zero pulling power in this bag of nails. It's rubbish. As a matter of fact, I don't even think it's got a turbo on it the way this is performing. This is a 30 mile an hour road. Yes, it is. It's very nice. I mean, look at it that way. I mean, look at this. You just want to crawl through this or anywhere, and you just have a good old peek at it and go, oh, this is nice, this is. It's very nice indeed, yes, it is. Yes. I know, I'm fucking cuckoo, but who cares? Enjoy. They've got some really nice houses down here, haven't they? Some really pretty stuff. They've really, really looked after nicely. Not like my bag of shit. If you could actually drive past my house, you'd probably think mine was like some sort of run-down, abandoned house, you know? It's like a ghost town. I'm in a ghost town. Right, we're off again. We can go. Wow. Oh, I mean, come on. Hey? Brought to you via Driver Jase, the extraordinaire of driving abilities. Ah, oh, tell you what. You couldn't ask for better, could you? I mean, look at it. Fucking look at it. I mean, you could look at it if you wanted to. You know what I mean, though, do you? It's just awesome. Absolutely awesome. That's huge, that, isn't it? It's massive, that, isn't it? That big hill there. Can you imagine trying to climb that fucker? Good grief. You get about 30 foot up there and you'd be planting your nuts up. Well, I would anyway. We got... That's steep, that, isn't it? Good grief. By the time we get back, the sun will have gone in and it'll be nice and dark, so the motorway will probably be a bit of a dark drive, I imagine. The last video I put up, I cut it short because the audio battery had died and it was just pointless. So I cut it short. It was about 2 hours, that was. It was good enough, I suppose. It was all right. Wasn't bad. But I've found, for some unknown reason, and I don't know why, I just don't know why, but if it's 3 hours plus, well, they have to be split into three because they're over 20 gig. I was lucky to get that one up, which was over 3 hours, which was 21.9. And they actually, YouTube accepted it. I mean, I was expecting to go, you know what I mean, like, too big. But now they had it. Fucking, that was a monster, that fucking thing was. Good grief. It's also taken a long time to render these ones as well. Like, we're talking 5 and 6 hours to render. Oh, that rings a bell. I remember that many, many moons ago. I was doing it, and it was for like an half an hour video. It would take about 4 hours to render, like, you know. But hey. So these, if I do these long ones, like 3+, I will break them down to like an hour segments. You know what I mean? Part ones to three. Or four, depending. You know, I might drop them down a bit more. You know, whatever. There's only so much I can do. So. There is only so much I can do for the new. Well, according to my twat nav, I'm doing a nice steady 49 miles an hour. You can't grumble at that. That's all right, that is. Nice steady road. It's reasonably well. It's flat enough. It's got a bit of a dip, bit of this, that, and the other, but yes. No apparent dangers so far. We've got no hidden edges or anything like that, or hidden entrances and exits and shit like that. So far, so good. Liking it. I just wish it had put me somewhere where I'm familiar with, because at the moment, I'm not, and I'm just driving blind. But I am keeping my papers open just in case, right? Yes, just in case this thing decides to play the funny fucker and send me somewhere where I can't go. Because that can happen. We don't want to get run into bridges, we don't want to get run into 7.5-ton limits. We shouldn't do that, will we? He says. I know. But, you know, we do try. I'm just wondering where this is going to end up, though. Because so far, I'm a bit like, I don't know. Is it going to be like this all the way home? I mean, that'd be fucking interesting, wouldn't it, if it was? It'd be very interesting. Can't do, though, can it? Because I did remember, when I looked at the thing, it went blah, 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 and then it was A40, M50, so no, it won't do it, so. Interesting. Oh well, just enjoy the ride. That's what I'm doing. I'm enjoying this bit anyway for now. Until he puts me somewhere I don't know. Straight over. Cabron. Is that Cabron? Is that how it's pronounced? It's got a funny little thing on the top of the A, so I don't know. Or is it Cabran? It's probably something Branate or Braun or whatever. I'm sure you will. She's a lad. It'll give me an idea how it's pronounced. Fuck's sake! Oh, good grief. I want to get out of this, you little twat. He's a nice personage. Thank you very much.
Isn't he
It was non-stop. I'd have been there all bleeding day.
Right then, where's this one taking us? It's looking interesting so far. Let's move our way. So Pap-Pap can get Pap-Pap me.
Pap-Pap can get Pap-Pap me.
I've no idea. I ain't going to change it. £50 an hour. Drop that down to Tooch. 49 Lou, happy days. See, look at me, you've got these types of houses as well, this style. Are they always like a sandstone as well, I wonder? Possibly. Nice bridge there as well. It was a pretend looking bridge. And you got that style, I mean. It's not bad at all. I mean, I like it. We're going down a hill, I know. Slow it down a bit then, I'm going to. Give me a break. There's an island at the bottom of the hill, you know. Oh no, I can see it. Look, it's there. We are going to go second left, apparently. The 4042. Now, the 4042 does ring a ding dong, it really does. Honestly. For some reason, I do remember the 4042. I think that might have something to do with Merthyr Tydfil. I think. I do remember a 4042, but I can't think where. Ooh, have a good innie. Have that. Ooh, I just seen a sign as well that says Usk. I know that one as well, that sounds familiar. Ooh. Must be on the right track then. You've got a bit of weight on you, so why on earth would you change gear when you're barely moving? You stupid fucking machine! Let's get gone. As you notice, we are driving down this bit of dual carriageway. It's got a lovely fresh bit of tarmac on it. Oh, nice. Posh and stuff. Oh. Can't beat a fresh bit of Mac. No. The best. Unless the people who have put it down were pissed one night and it's like that, but you know, that does happen. Not very often, but it does. Well, what have we got now? Ooh. We can only go that way, particularly anyway, so. Yes. Well, we weren't going where I thought we'd be going. We're going somewhere else, by the looks of it. So, oh well. We're not going to go for the construction site. Dang and blast it. Ah, that's a bit of a pig bag, isn't it? It's a bit of a pig bag. Never mind, not to worry. Keep going. Didn't notice. See, change gear at 1,000 revolutions. Change gear then. It should actually change gear at around about 1,500. No. Rubbish. Absolute rubbish. So, what neck of the woods are we at now then, I wonder? Where's this? That looks like it's been abandoned, whatever that place is, or was. I wonder what that was originally. Where am I? Where the fuck am I? I don't know. Apparently this is Usk Road. I imagine that's how it's pronounced. I mean, I don't know. I'm only guessing. Straight over. No, what? Hang on. Scratching the old bonce a minute. Nah. I'm imagining things. Nah. I just have it there. Hoover? Was I right or was I right? Oh, well, fuck me. Have that. Tell you what, you know, sometimes I do surprise myself. Hey, you know, sometimes that was a bit of a fluke, that was, I think, personally.
A bit of a fluke.
Well, I can't go that way. It's got a 14-foot-3 bridge. So I'm going to go this way instead. Keep on trucking, keep on driving. Cause one day you're gonna get through it, you're gonna get there now. Oh yeah. Slowing down. Why? Because now it's not now. It's only a 50 mile an hour road now. Come on, you. Oh, you fucking fucktard. Come on. See what I mean? Blah. I ain't that heavy. Really, honest, I'm not. I think I've got wrapping paper, I think. That's all I got. It's not mega heavy. Unbelievable. Un-fucking-leavable. Single lane traffic. Right then, let's take a nice little jolly down this neck of the woods and see what we can find. There is one thing I will be pissed off at, is if my cameras aren't working on the back. You know, one isn't on, but it's on, but not recording. I have them terrible feelings sometimes when they're just like, oh, please, no, don't do it. Clippity-clop, clippity-clop, clippity-clippity, clippity-clop. Ooh, sliding back down again. Well, I am, because as you can see, it's a bit of a windy, bendy bit here, right? And like I've stated before, just because it says it's Kenya, and you have to think about what you've got on the back here, right? You can't just go, and I've had a look at what I've got on the back of me, it's like, well, it's all right to a point. You know what I mean? It can withstand a certain amount of weeble wobbles, you know, but not a great deal. Hence the reason why I'm going around here at like 20 fucking 5 miles an hour, like, you know what I mean? So it's just a bit of forethought, that's all. You just think about these things. Use your noggin. I'm trying to get that through to them frigging pal. Oh no. Them two drivers, they were fucking rubbish. Well, I only had the one. No. Don't win the corner that fast, fuck's sake! I know it's not fair, but I had to do it again. Fuck that. No. My life is worth a lot more. You know, I'm sat over there. I need to trust the fucker who's sitting here. I haven't got dual controls, have I? No. I'll tell you what, I could do with having them, though. I say that now. And some of these people. I ain't kidding you, honestly. It's fucking debatable. This here, I mean, you couldn't ask for better, could you? You really couldn't. It's got some lovely windy bendy bits. As long as you take them at a reasonable pace, you're all right. You ain't gonna go mad. Nice and fluid motion, fluid movements through the bends. No quick jerking. Counter it properly. Read the road. Assess it as you come to it. And it's great fun. See, this is the only thing I say about when you're coming down country lanes, right, when you're driving down them, right, it's no good trying to react to them when you're on top of the situation, like this bend here. As I'm looking at it, I'm already thinking about how to approach it before I get to it. Looking at the road bends, it's got a slight camber off to the left and a tilt to the left, which is good for me, because you don't want an adverse one, because if it goes round to the left but tilts to the right, then you've got to watch your speed and slow down, because you'd be going like that, be a lot like this. And you don't want that. And you got to watch for dips as well, the way the road bends and swells and turns. It's, you know, you got to read it and see it and go, right, I want to get around there and I need to be this speed. I need to approach it from that angle, that point, that there. You know, there's a lot of shit that goes on automatic as time goes. If you learn and do it, you know, and think about it first, and eventually it comes naturally. You're already there. You've already drove past it in your mind anyway. And then when you approach it, you do it. You know what I mean? It's weird, isn't it? Well, that's how I do it. But that was because most of my teens and sort of like early 20s, I was a motorbike rider anyway before I had this thing. So I used that ability, you know, to read the road and understand how it flows. which has helped me out. I thought this bit here, speed limit dropped, but the road is going to drop down enough to the left. So I'm thinking, well, I need to be a slightly hour just enough to bring it round. You know, I'm already thinking about that. So, but it's just, I don't know, maybe it's just me. I like the thing of these things, and obviously going through a built-up area because it's 40 miles an hour, but kiddlywink sign, yes, I know it's late now and there's no kiddlywinks about, but, you know, elderly crossings and stuff like that, and the fact that it dips up, twists off to the left, but it's turning to the right. It's not very noticeable, but at speed it can be, you know what I mean? Wall sticking out, judge it so you get past the wall so you don't interfere with the traffic there. Tree, top of that bit there. Watching it as it goes round, making sure I'm far enough over so the top of the trailer don't clip clop of the tree, because it might not affect the trailer, as in it won't damage it, but you'll be throwing shit off behind you, so people behind you get showered in shit, like, you know what I mean, which can distract their driving. Oh, I'll tell you what, mate, there's a lot of things that you have to think about when you're driving down country lanes. Yes, it is a lot of fun, I will admit. I do enjoy driving down country lanes. Driving down country lanes is the tits. No two ways about it. And it's nice to be able to see sights like this and, you know, and have the ability to admire it as you're driving down here. You know, it's fucking brilliant. But apparently, according to my twat box here, I'm going to go all the way down here and come all the way back up again for some reason. I don't know why. I wonder. You see, looking at that there, and then it's going to go back up that street there. I'm just wondering, you know, if I'm going to be slap dab on the 40 a bit earlier than what I thought. Well, that's boring. I was enjoying this. But look at that there. I mean, if it wasn't for the fact it's a hill, it looks like a mountain. It's fucking cool. I love it. It's like Back to the Future, ain't it? Welcome to the Ninja Channel. Brought to you by Safari Park. Do-ba-do-ba-do. You know what I mean? Great, ain't it? It comes the band again. Slowing it down because we don't want to crash. Signpost again, look, see, the one up there that says 40 miles an hour, slow it down. I want to be doing 40 before I get to it, thanks, because there's a bit of a and a bit sort of thing, you know what I mean? See, you gotta think, look ahead, drive ahead, don't try and react to it before it happens. You see what I mean? Look, see, can't go down there though. No, I'm down here, but I can't go down there. Look at this here, I mean, you know. Fucking 40 down here, are you taking the piss? Oh, 15, thank you very glad. Oh, I mean, you got a fucking whoomp back bitch here, look, yeah. You don't say that every day, do you?
I'm not gonna ground it.
Oh, tell you what, I am so glad I put the cameras on today. Oh, fucking love it. See, look at that. Klaus Encounters of the Fourth Kind. Ding, 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 ding. Well, at the end of the day, look at it. That's the fucking tits. I love that. Oh, dear. That is fucking awesome. Oh, love a duck. Absolutely brilliant. Keep your eyes peeled, people, because in the next... I reckon next year we are going to be in a full alien invasion. We are. We're going to be attacked by them. They're coming at us. They're going to fucking probe us in all sorts of orifices. I'm telling you now, honestly. But the way they keep going about it, you'd think they would be. Well, they might land on that. Looks like a proper landing spot that does, doesn't it? Proper UFO site, that one there. Yeah. As a matter of fact, I mean, I'd looking at that there, I reckon that'd be a good place for like hand gliding and shit like that, personally. Like, you know, I mean, that's the sort of thing that's just popped in my head. You know, parasending or paragliding or hand gliding or whatever, some sort of shit like that, you know. As a matter of fact, there might even be a name for it, you know, there might be some posh name for it or whatever, I don't fucking know. You lot can tell me, you have a look, go on. Scootle off, go and do a YouTube search or a Google search for it. Oh, here we are, look, here we go. Oh, I see. You've come the boring way around. Oh, all right then. Fucking miserable bastard. That's the thingamajig there, all the heads of the valley shit is from up back then, I think. If I'm not mistaken. The heads of the valley, I think it's from up that way. Because this is the wonky bit that I always get wonkified on. Because it makes me go wonky. I always end up wonking it. Well, I'll tell you what though. Aye, it's another road that I've found that I can use. Happy fucking days. Oh, for telling you, this thing couldn't pull itself out of a fucking bath. Come here. See, I put my foot down and fuck all happens. And it's like, oh, hang on a minute. Give me now, fuck them all. It's a bag of shit. It's a bag of shit. Yay! I gotta go round the yard. All the way round the yard. And then I'm gonna go up a yard. Stay in this line of yard. Winkle all the way round the yard. North and steady. Not too fast. And then I've got to go all the way around here. Oh, yes. See? Now I know where I am. That's it. Fun over. And the rest of this bit now is boring. Geez, hey, we've done this bit before, haven't we? That bit we haven't, but this is... I'll have to find something interesting to talk about now, won't I? Oh, fucking hell, man. How do I do that? You can always look at that though, that's not bad. Not bad at all. The Midlands! The Midlands! Happy days. From pit down here like a good one. It is now 4:20 in the afternoon. Oof. And according to that, I've still got 99 miles to go. 99 problems, but I got 99 miles, but well, that was a bit of a fucking letdown, wasn't it? Dunno. It started off good, but hey, whatever. Never mind. Sounds like the haunted house of some sort. He's sitting there and he's in the wind whistling to the doors. Told you. It's just now good, boring. And now I'm yawning now. Look, see? Told you. Once me fucking me attention span's gone, I'm fucked. Nothing to talk about now. I can talk about all sorts of crap other than... Yeah. I'm thinking. Bear with me. I'm trying to dig some of the archives out of my head. Thank you. was I watching this morning? I was watching... that was Vibes. I think it was a small five-minute video. I think it was Richard Dawkins, I think. Something to do with... stupid design, right? Bear with me. It was proving the fact of evolution and not being designed, right? And apparently, from the brain, right, to the voice box, there's a nerve, right? Now, it should go from the brain to the voice box. No, actually it doesn't. This nerve goes all the way down here, goes all the way around there, and comes all the way back up again, and comes into here. Right? Which, like he says, it's by design, right? It's because evolution, as it starts off from way back when, this nerve was apparently, regulated the gills of the fish, right? That's what it was, right? This is what it did, right? This is what it was all about. This nerve regulated the gills of the fish, or a fish-like creature. And as it evolved through years and time, this thing, then obviously the animal changed, it went onto land, blah, blah, blah. And it still went down there, but as it came back up again, as the throat starts to form, and then the vocal cords start to form, and but it just went like that and came back up again. It got longer and longer and longer and further away. But it was never altered. It just evolved with the species evolving along with it. Which was proven by this necrotopsy with a giraffe. And they found the nerve from the brain stem, followed it, and it went all the way down to its heart, wrapped around one of these major veins or vessels, where it was, and come back up again, and he's like, bloody hell, he's right, you know. Which is just another, you know, reason why we wasn't just magically made, because if we was, well then, you'd have had that particular nerve come from the brainstem and go straight to the voice box. Because that is, by design, how it should be. But through evolution, it's gone all the way down there and comes all the way back up again. And that, I found that extremely interesting. Whether you lot do or not, I don't know, but I found it really interesting. So you've got to revolve. Simple. I mean, it's a fact, it's there. It's in black and white, or should I say in gooey guts and blood, it's there. It tells you. Believe it as you wish, it's up to you, I don't mind. You can, if you think that's ludicrous and it don't make sense, then that's entirely up to you. But it was there, they showed you, that's what it was. I was quite surprised, I was amazed. Brilliant. I like things like that, little interesting tidbits like that, you know, because always then it furthers the fact that, well, you know, it just makes sense. Yeah. We don't just all of a sudden pop up, we evolved. Yeah, and we probably wasn't the only thing that evolved originally, you know. I mean, I can get back on that subject again. I'm